everybody. It's your man, Fitman. And today, we're gonna learn about the three keys needed to perform one of my favorite old school quad builders, the barbell hack squat. Now, the barbell hack squat is a very, very archaic movement. You're not going to see many trainees performing this movement in today's fitness culture. But back in the 1900s, when squat racks were not as available as they are now, trainees still needed a way to train their quads hard and heavy. This is when the great lifter George Hackenschmidt decided to create the barbell hack squat. Now, even though Hackenschmidt brought this gem of a movement into the fitness arena, it's not performed often. Why? One, it feels awkward, and two, it looks awkward. But success requires struggle, and if you're able to master the barbell hack squat, you will unlock the true potential of your quads. So today, I'm gonna present to you the three keys that are gonna allow you to perform the barbell hack squat with maximum efficiency. So let's get into it right now. So to perform effective and efficient barbell hack squats, you have to have the correct form. You don't want to get folded and butcher your back performing incorrect barbell hack squats. What we need to do is learn about how to do this move correctly. There are three keys that we need to learn about. The first one, if you'll notice before we get into anything, we have a wooden block on the ground. This wooden block allows us to elevate our heels during the movement to put the maximum stimulation on the quads, okay? The key is to really make the quads work by elevating the heel. You're gonna hit those quads even harder. So the first thing that we need to do when we get into our barbell hack squat as far as form, the bar is set up behind us, okay? That's the first awkward part about this move. It freaks people out, all right? But that's the key to it. You're gonna take a nice grip. It can be a mixed or an overhand. It really does not matter, okay? You're gonna pull up on that bar. Get the slack out of it. The first step, you're gonna sit back. All right, we have a tall chest and our knees are out, everything's tight. Explode up, okay? And we're squatting back down. We're not bending over, all right? We're squatting back down. That's a basic barbell hack squat. The first step was to sit back, keep the chest forward, eyes forward. Number two, the path of the bar. So a lot of folks, when they get into the barbell hack squat, what do? They lock it in, okay? They pull the slack out the bar, the chest is up. They pull that bar right into their body, into their hamstrings, and now they can't complete the move. And then they quit, which is the wrong thing to do. What you have to do, the bar has to be slightly away, ever so slightly away from your body so that you're not pulling it into your hamstrings. So we're dropped down. We gotta pull the slack out the bar. Our chest is tall, knees out, and what I'm doing is that bar is slightly away from my body so that I have zero contact with my hamstrings, all right? Now I squat back down, okay? Big squat, tap that floor, and bring them up. Pow, all right? And squat down, upper body nice and tight, okay? This is 135, I can already feel my quads cooking, okay? And there's barely any weight on here, all right? Third step to performing effective barbell hack squats. So what have we learned? We've learned about pulling the slack out the bar. We've learned about dropping our hips, chest up, eyes forward. We stand up, the bar is away from us. The third step, you've got to squat down. Don't bend over or you're going to get folded, okay? So squat down, nice tight chest, and we're straight down into it. Right into the squat, pow, and rise, okay? And squatting back down, and pow. This is how we are going to build the maximum quads that your body can build. So I want to show you how this looks from the front so that when you're practicing in the gym, you can see exactly how you should look in a mirror. So when you are performing the barbell hack squat in the gym, it is crucial for you as a beginner in the movement, even if you're a little more advanced in the movement, to use the mirror to make sure everything is locked in, to make sure that your chest is up, to make sure that your knees are out, to make sure that your eyes are forward, and to make sure that you have the correct form, all right? So you should look just like me when you are performing this move in the gym, okay? So we're gonna lock it in, and what are we doing? We're pulling up on the bar. There's no slack in the bar, all right? We're sinking those hips down. Our knees are out. Maximum stimulation, the quads, tall chest, tight, and explode, okay? Now, we're squatting down, okay? Squatting down. Tall chest, eyes forward, kiss that floor, and stand, okay? That's the barbell hack squat. We're gonna squat down again, and pow. You master this move. If you can get this move into your program, you are gonna really unlock the potential of your quads. So those are the three keys to performing effective and efficient barbell hack squats. Again, this is a great move to add into your program. It's very back friendly. If you're worried about the knees, I've had zero knee issues since I started performing this movement 9-10 years ago. So it's a very safe movement. It's gonna allow you to really maximize and unlock the development in your quads. And another great thing about the barbell hack squat is that it allows you to train your quads with heavy weight without putting a lot of stress on the back. If you use the barbell hack squat consistently and you give me that CQE, that consistent quality effort, you will be able to bring the strength of your barbell hack squat very close to the strength of your maximum deadlift. I thank you for watching the video. It's your man, Fitman. Holla at a trainer when you see me in the gym.